Hello everybody, welcome back. I am Evan Archer, and if you are new to my channel, I want you to know this is the first Pokemon video I've ever done. Normally I do movie reviews and shit posts and pop culture commentary, but today I wanted to talk about one of my newest addictions. Now, when I was about 14 years old in junior high, I got really into Pokemon cards, like most young people my age did. And around the age of 30, I got back into them because YouTube takes you down holes, and sometimes they introduce you back to things you used to love, and if you have obsessive compulsive disorder, sometimes you jump back in hardcore, and yeah, that's what happened to me. I'm at the age of 31, wildly addicted to the cardboard crack, which is known as Pokemon cards. And since I've been reintroduced to this this collecting, I've discovered that there's a lot more bullshit than there was when I was a kid. Now, when I was a kid, if a store had Pokemon cards, you'd go there, and the dick kids would pull all the cards off the rack and separate them up so no one else could have any. Now, the dick moves that people are pulling are stuff we didn't know you could do back then, but now it's a lot easier to do because of the way they make these cards. The big thing that people are doing right now, and I assume I've been doing for years, is weighing Pokemon card packs in the store before they buy them, so they get all of the rares, or at least the uncommons, and then leave all the trash for everybody else who's unexpecting. This is the worst thing about this is it happens online. One thing you should know is you should never, ever purchase single Pokemon card packs online. You should buy them in person at stores. Or buy full boxes that are factory sealed, because when someone buys like a full booster box, what most of these people online do, including stores, not just individual people, is they will take the packs and they will weigh all of them, and they will take out the heaviest packs, because premium cards, EXs, GXs, holofoils, just reverse holos, anything that is slightly more valuable, they keep for themselves and then sell you the trash at market price. And I'm going to prove that today. Now, the way that a lot of people do this, that I was introduced to this concept when I discovered that Dollar Tree offers $1 Pokemon packs. Now, these $1 packs contain three cards. And three cards, if one card is heavier than all three others, it's going to throw the weight off noticeably. Now, if you go and look at Pokemon cards in stores right now, you will see that they're all covered in cardboard holder. And I did some experiments where I went and I weighed these packs in stores. I didn't buy all of them or anything like that. I just bought like a handful to test this theory. And those cardboard sleeves throw things off by quite a lot. So I wanted to show you guys what's going on by using these $1 packs, because there's a lot less material and a lot more you can determine by weighing. Now, remember, when you weigh these packs, just because one of these packs is heavier does not mean you're getting a great card. It just means that there's a holofoil in it, even though it could just be a reverse common. All the cards in these newest sets have reverses and reverse holofoils, so that can throw off the weight too. So even if you do this method, you might not get anything great, but your chances go up more. I want to start, well, we're 4 minutes in, but I do want to start this video out by saying, if you go to a store and you grab all the decks and you weigh them and take all the heavy ones, you're a dick. But if there's a ton of cards there and you just want to buy one or two, I'm okay with you weighing and buying like the two heaviest packs you see. That's not really a dick move. It's not entirely honest, but it's not as egregious as some of the shit these people online do. But I wanted to show you this by example. Now, I went to Dollar Tree and I bought all of the Forbidden Light packs they had left. They only had 17. I didn't buy a whole box, and they had a lot more cards there that weren't just Forbidden Light, so I don't feel that guilty. And I brought them all home. I didn't weigh them in the store because, you know, for this experiment, that was kind of stupid, because I could have gone to a store where people just weighed all the packs in the store, because people do that with these scales, but I didn't want to do that. I wanted to take a risk, so I grabbed all the ones that I wanted, all the newest packs I wanted. I came home and I weighed them, and I was lucky enough that no one did that in the store. I bought 17 packs. These are the lightest packs, and these were the heavier packs. Now, what I wanted to do, I went through and I weighed these all before because I wanted to save you guys the time in this video, even though we're at the 5-minute mark. But I want to show to you. Now, I know you probably can't see this with this camera and this lighting right now, but I want to show you. Okay. This is one of the lighter packs. 38.70. 38.70. Here's one of the heavier packs. 3895. So there's something in here that's a little heavier than in here. The same will happen with this one. Tilt. All right. 38.75. A little heavier. 3930. So all of these are slightly heavier than all of these. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to open a couple of these for you and see if we get anything good. Hell, I think I might just cut the tops off these. I'm going to take a cut in the video. Before I start opening these cards, I want to, some of you might be asking, where do you get a scale like this? What store do you go to? Well, normally these are sold at tobacco shops. They sell these right next to the cans of Mountain Dew where you can unscrew the top and there's a thing you can hold materials in where people won't think it's not weed. Anyway, also, if you don't want to go to one of those stores, go to your local mall and look for a store that sells tie-dye t-shirts, hemp jewelry, incense, katana swords. They will definitely sell this too right next to the water pipes. So yeah, that's where you get one of these. This one ran me about $15, just so you know what to expect. All right, so I just cut the tops off all of these light packs. Let's see if I get anything good. Maybe there are some cards in here that are good. They're just not very heavy. Let's see. Nothing good there. All right. I'm going to open these all rapid fire. I'm not going to talk about them much. I just want to see if we get anything shiny. Oh, look, nothing shiny. The shine is always my favorite part. I don't care if it's a reverse holo. Ah, I'm disappointed with that one. Hold up. It's getting... Okay, sorry. It's getting kind of blurry. Anything here? Nothing. Here? Nothing. All right. Here? Nothing. Anything here? Nothing. How about here? There might be something here. I can feel it. I can feel it. There's something here. Oh, look, there's nothing. Okay. I can totally feel it this time. I just feel it in my bones. It's the second to last pack. Huh. There doesn't seem to be anything in these super light packs that you can just weigh and then screw people over. Let's see. Last pack magic. Nothing. All right. Well, looks like the light packs don't give you anything. Let's see what happens if you weigh a pack in the store and then buy all the, nice heavy packs. Alright, just cut the tops off of these 7 packs. Okay, let's see what we get in the first one. Alright, useless card. Oh, look. There's some shine. It's not a rare, but it is a holo. It's a reverse. Let's see if we get anything shiny in this one. Okay. Didn't get anything in that one. Let's see if overall I'm proved right. Oh, look. A shiny. 2 out of 3. Ain't bad. You know what would be cool? If I pulled something super rare and good. Not really. But there's shine. Alright, we got 3 packs left. You know, I don't really care if I pull anything. I'm proving my point pretty well. Not in this one, but you get where I'm going with this. Okay, I'm gonna feel like a super asshole if like these next two are not shiny at all. Kind of feeling like an asshole, but you get where I'm coming from. There is something to this. Okay, I'm not posting this. Okay, I was joking about that. I am posting this because I was still proven right most of the time. We did get only shinies in the heavier packs, which leads me to believe that maybe someone may have went through, because all of the packs that were in the box that I purchased, they were all mixed up and in different boxes. There were three different boxes along the row. So there was like Ultra Prism, and there was Roar, XY, I think. But I wanted the Forbidden Light because there's such good cards in here. I was proven right. There were no really good cards, but you can measure these. The overall point I wanted to make with this video is that you should be iffy about buying single packs that aren't the ones covered in cardboard, especially online. Okay, the only two shiny cards were in the packs that weighed more, so I do feel like I made my point. I wish I had a better outcome, but yeah, ever since I've been getting back into buying these cards, I have seen so many scams, and I've seen so many people try to fuck over basically kids and 31-year-old nerds like me. But yeah, I just wanted to make this video. I know my channel isn't huge right now, but maybe someday in the future, another nerd who doesn't want to get screwed over sees this video and maybe saves some money. So yeah, thank you all so much for watching. I will see you in the next video. It will be more professional than this, I promise. Bye!